So we're heading over to a shed where I have some wood storage. And we'll grab some, or we'll look at some cypress. Been sitting here for, Lord, 2 or 3 years. That's better. Yeah, good deals, I got plenty. Okay, so here's the cypress that I'm gonna use to cut the body of the birdhouse. Here's my table saw, hooked up in my old carpenter box. I used to travel around the country, put it on wheels, got an air compressor, got everything I need, just fold the runoff table down. Anyway, I'm going to plane them, get them smooth, and then probably cut the bird holes in them and hook them up. We'll get to that later. This is all cypress. These octagons here are the size of the smaller square that you see on the table now. So now that I have the octagon size laid out for the floor, that's going to go underneath the octagon laid out for the birdhouse, you find the center right here by the diagonal, and that's the distance that you're going to have to mark your octagon with. I don't have a compass large enough, so I made this little jig. Now all we do is connect the dots. After I connect the boards to this width and mill them out to that square width, and then I'll cut this template out and I'll draw my octagon on the boards that I use for the floors. Okay, so now we've got to biscuit joint these together. Here we go. So I made these a little thicker. These will be the dividers between each housing section, and this will be the bottom, and it'll be attached to, I don't know, 10 inch like wooden telephone pole about 15 feet high. I like the bottom thicker. Thought I'd go ahead and make it that way for cosmetic purposes, aesthetics, I don't know. So I just like it thicker on the bottom. Okay, so here's the three floors. The bottom one there is much thicker, and then the second level and the third level. All right, so we've got to route out a slot here for, you know, the feet of the birds so they can catch on. The other one was flat. The original. I'm just putting some little touches to it. So I'll start off with about half the slot deep, and we'll go on from there. Okay, so here's the roundover bit I used to make the roundovers on the edges, the feet placements, the entry holes. Pretty sweet, nice and round, and it's pretty much self-explanatory.
So these will be rough dividers to separate each hotel room for the birds. We'll rip them out on the bandsaw here.
So here's what I cut out on the bandsaw. As you can tell, they came out pretty nice. They're just rough. They don't have to be perfect. Two boards, cut them in half. They call that resawn. And then what you get is this. And they go in the middle there of the hotel rooms just to divide them up a little bit. So, everybody will have a front and back door, huh? Or what, two side doors? Two front doors. There you go. All right, good deals. So here's the base of the roof. I guess it's the frame and the decking with some roofing paper on it. And I'll start adding the shingles here next. So here's the base of the roof. I guess it's the frame and the decking with some roofing paper on it. And I'll start adding the shingles here next. Okay, here are the pieces that I'm going to put on the hips of the roof. I'm going to have to cut them down to 2 inches a piece. Right now they're gluing. Remember, I cut them on the table saw at about a 15 degree angle on each side. And then I went and glued them together so they look like that. And then if I cut them here, like somewhere like that, I can put them on the roof hip, one on top of the other, you know, and just build them up all the way to the top. But right now, they're just drying.